offenders live near your home, you can check the state registry easily enough.
Yeah, but problem is some offenders try to stay off the radar by failing to register their address.
And that includes 41-year-old Charles Hardy Martin. He was convicted of sexually assaulting a child in 2009. Well, now he's accused of assaulting a 5-year-old girl near 11th and Martha. The case has one local group telling us they wish they could do more to check up on offenders.
Tonight's I-Team report comes from KETV NewsWatch 7's Christina Engdahl.
When it comes to people who hurt kids, Rebecca Berrientos-Padlin says it should be one strike and you're out.
First-time offenders should be only a first-time offender and never let out.
The mission of her organization, a hand to hold, only strengthened by another attack.
He just got out and then what, he offends again? That poor little girl.
Charles Hardy Martin sexually assaulted a child in 2008. Now police think he hurt a little girl.
Our job then is to make sure that you're where you say you are. So if you tell us that you're at this location, we have deputies that go out and check those locations to make sure that you are where you say you are.
But the sex offender registry shows Hardy Martin lied, listing Sienna Francis House as his residence while he was actually living in this South Omaha home.
Well, we have about 940 sex offenders registered in Douglas County. Of course, it's our goal to check on them as often as we can.
The Nebraska State Patrol tells me checking on them may not always happen. A sex offender is only required to show up for verification. Making sure they're being truthful is up to authorities.
I think every law enforcement agency would like to have more resources to do a more thorough job.
Psychologist Dr. Kent Newring says the streets can be safe with sex offenders, but says it can sometimes be a lifelong process of treatment and risk management. But Rebecca Berrientos-Padlin says she isn't willing to wait, so she's sending letters to state leaders now.
They've done something bad enough to be in there, then they need to stay in there because we don't want them on the streets.
In Omaha, Christina Engdahl, KETV, NewsWatch 7.